There she was, Eclipsa Butterfly, Queen of Darkness, moments away from liberating her monster love after briefly swapping bodies with Rhombulus. It was only after Star talked Eclipsa down that Mewni's current queen decided Globgor can't be freed by her own accord. Eclipsa's going to have to play the game fair and square. Or that's what she thinks. In a show titled Star vs. the Forces of Evil, we obviously know who the main character is, Star Butterfly herself. And thus, she's going to be the one making big decisions. And by the end of this Mewni mayhem, you will know why Star will be the one to free Globgor. I'm your host, Ostrich Fox, and I think I figured out just how Globgor will be freed. Of course, I'm going to issue a spoiler warning, just in case I'm remotely right. And with all of that said, let's dive in. I mentioned in a previous video centered around Lake House Fever that Star's character seems to have regressed a bit in Season 4. Well, really in the episode it began to progress. Conquer, embracing her duties as queen, stating that the inhabitants of Mewni are her people. Yet, by the episode's end, she relinquishes the throne back to Eclipsa. By, who of all accounts, technically shouldn't have it. Emotionally, you could argue it was stolen from Eclipsa. The throne at the very least should have gone to her daughter, Meteora. And yes, the Magical High Commission is completely in the wrong for sabotaging such a thing. But we must remember, Eclipsa abandoned the kingdom. That already puts her at a disadvantage. She is very grateful that Star had a change of heart. But that's the thing. Star really shouldn't have had a change of heart. She should have kept the throne and aided Eclipsa from there. And I think the episode Swimsuit gave us a glimpse at Star's involvement in Globgor's liberation. Star was the one who vouched for Eclipsa to have a trial. Star was the one to free Eclipsa of her handcuffs after learning the truth of the Butterfly family. And once more, Star was the one who gave Eclipsa the throne. As you can see, Star has been pretty active in advancing Eclipsa's storyline. So already, it makes the most narrative sense for Star to be the one to free Globgor. When looking at Eclipsa's character arc, she could have freed Globgor right then at that very moment. After all, she does what she has to do for herself.
I did what I had to do for me. The Magic High Commission and your mother think that's evil.
Call me a villainess.
Her best interest has always been above everyone else, until the events of Conquer, where she attempted to end the life of her own child to protect the Kingdom of Mewni. And the sentiment is reiterated at the end of Swimsuit. The kingdom comes first.
Want your hubby back. And Rhombulus, you and the rest of the Magical High Commission have your reasons for not wanting to free Globgor.
Star is the mediator. She has constantly mediated tensions between Eclipsa and the Magical High Commission, between monsters and all of humans. Despite her being very hesitant of adapting the title, she, in a lot of ways, has never ceased to be the acting queen of Mewni. She was kind of already the acting queen before Moon went missing. I think it's pretty evident that the Magical High Commission is stuck in their ways. They aren't going to budge. Moon herself doesn't trust Eclipsa, but respects that Star made a decision. By all accounts, Moon could have easily tried to take the throne from Eclipsa. But no, she's going to let Star's decision play out. You guys get the point. It all comes back to Star. Here's the thing though. Star doesn't really know much about Globgor. She can learn from the High Commission, she can learn from her mother, and she can learn from Eclipsa herself. Yet, I think there's one person she trusts above all of the aforementioned. Glosseric. She knows Glosseric likes to play mind games. She knows Glosseric never makes anything easy. But Glosseric will supply information when need be, even if it is in the form of a riddle. Now, I believe that Globgor won't be freed until the mid-season finale, Coronation, which is something I could really talk about all in a separate video just because I feel as if I have a potentially great idea for where that episode could go. But as that is the midpoint of the season and a half-hour episode, I just don't see Globgor awakening until then. But how can it be done? I don't see Eclipsa jacking Rhombulus' body again. It would backtrack her lesson and just be repetitive. And I don't see Rhombulus budging. So it makes sense that a third party would have to liberate Globgor. But if it's not Rhombulus' magic, the only thing that could free Globgor is a spell. But there's no magic in the world, no spell that could do such a thing, right? Well, that's where the Book of Spells has us covered. I've noticed that the Star team loves dramatic irony. So of course, the queen who detested monsters the most, who tried to commence a monster genocide, will be the one who causes Globgor the king of monsters, to be freed. I am, of course, talking about Eclipsa's very own mother, Solaria Butterfly. Yeah, that in itself is already dramatic irony. The queen who wants to commit monster genocide is the mother of the one who would become queen and run off of a monster. Alright, but Solaria's out of the picture. How could she possibly be responsible for a future event? Well, there's a spell in her chapter, the Crystal Pulverizing Spell. Let's read, shall we? The Crystal Pulverizing Spell is a favorite of mine. It works on all crystals, especially the crystals Rhombulus shoots from his head and snake hands in order to trap evildoers. This spell is very helpful when Rhombulus accidentally crystallizes a Mewni in the heat of battle. Guaranteed to pulverize any and all crystals you may encounter while on your journey. So, there you have it. This spell is meant to break Rhombulus's crystals, because in war, Mewmins had a habit of being crystallized. Plus, we saw all the crystals in this domain. Yikes. But it seems Eclipsa does not know about this spell. And I'm assuming Star would also be blissfully unaware. It seems as if Eclipsa and Star just weren't for reading the Book of Spells. And now that's kind of biting them in the butt. Alright, but the Book of Spells is destroyed, right? It can't be recovered. Well, that's where you're wrong again. You see, when the Book of Spells was released in stores, it kind of drops a bombshell on you at the end that you need to read between the lines in order to understand. At the point in time we were reading the Book of Spells, as Season 4 was yet to be released, this book, for all intents and purposes, comes from the future, after the book is restored. Let's read a certain excerpt, Glossaric's Thoughts on the Future. In closing, now that you've made this book your own, it's time to think about the future of this book, because as we all know, it has a very funny way of catching on fire. And whenever it burns again, as we all know it's going to, its owner, that's you, will be tasked with its reconstruction. So just keep any old piece of the book, and then place one of my lovely silkworms on top of that piece to bring the book back into existence. It doesn't matter how charred it is. My silkworms aren't too picky. Might I recommend Silky? She's got a real eye for detail, and is just as sweet as a piece of Comet's pudding pie. Now that's a lot of sweets. Now of course, I want all of my kids to have equal opportunities. Stinky could definitely help a new book owner out, but you'll have to proofread like a hawk. He could accidentally on purpose give you a false entry or 10. Don't bother with Sassy Pants Sassafras. She's not one to be told what to do. You may end up with a ceiling fan instead of a spell book. So there we have it. The Book of Spells can be restored from a piece of the book. Huh, if only there was a— Wait, Star held onto a piece? The same piece that revived Glossaric, but we don't know if it's out of the picture. Plus, if she held onto that piece, there may be many more out there. Glossaric and his elusive mind games over these next episodes leading to Coronation may steadily guide to Star to restoring the book in the show proper. Season 4 has included a lot of the book already in its episodes. So why should I doubt the Book of Spells itself won't return? Once Star restores the book, she'll learn of the Crystal Pulverizing Spell. Tensions will come to a head, and just as Star made the call for a lot of significant events in the series before, she'll make the call to free Globgor. Eclipsa won't be the one responsible. Of course, the kingdom can't blame Eclipsa if Star is the one to free Globgor. She's the one with the say, and she should be the one to become queen. What happens from there? Well, we can't exactly see the future. But Glossaric can.
You know, even though I knew this was coming, it's still kind of a surprise.
And I feel as if he knows Globgor is needed for something. Maybe for the same reason Toffee is needed. Just that Globgor will be on the other side of history. If you guys haven't seen the Toffee theory yet, go check it out. That's pretty much it. Star will be the one to free Globgor, and there's a way to free him. She just needs to learn the spell from the spellbook itself. But what do you guys think? Should Star free Globgor? Do you see it happening? Why or why not? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below, or tweet your thoughts at RoundtableVids, and for my own thoughts, you can find me at OshaVods. We're also on Instagram. Help the Roundtable grow by either becoming a member of this channel or supporting us over at Patreon. Links to everything in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please order a like and subscribe to the Roundtable so you never miss any great cartoon content. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have an awesome day. OshaVods, out.